Welcome to virtual VEX Code VR tutorial and challenge for the Skills Ontario International Day of the Girl, Tuesday, October 11th, 2022. My name is Michael Frankfort. I'm a curriculum consultant with the York Region District School Board. Please note that this tutorial is available in both English and French, and the slide decks are also available in both languages. The bit.lys are located at the bottom. Hashtag for posting is on the bottom left with VR coding robotics. This tutorial will cover some aspects of coding in mathematics and science and tech curriculums, and we'll be looking at the VEX Code VR as well as exploring some activities, looking at a challenge, and then some coding resources that could be used directly into the classroom with students and teachers. If you look at coding in the mathematics curriculum, a code is an instruction or set of instructions that can be executed by a computer or other device. The process of writing computer programming instructions is what coding is. And as you'll see in the next slide, the coding expectations have a progression that flow through grades 6, 7, 8, and then to 9. You'll notice that the highlighted areas is what is the progression through the grades, and it sits in the elementary curriculum in strand C at the expectation C3.1 and 0.2, and then in grade 9 in the C strand as well with C2.1, 2, and 3. The science curriculum has coding embedded in strand A, which is the STEM expectations. And you can see the highlighted sections with grades 6, 7, 8, as well as the progression into grade 9. So VEXCode VR. VEXCode VR is based on a physical robot, the VEX robot, and this is a VR platform with a simulated robot. If you look at the bottom right of the screen, you'll see the website that you can use to access the free platform and software. So essentially, when you're looking at the VEXCode VR, the VR refers to the virtual robot, and it's a web-based tool. You don't really need to have any software to download. The program has free playgrounds, and there's a really good number of them. And then if schools or districts would like to pay for a premium, there's a subscription model available. It should function on all desktops, laptops, MacBooks, and for teachers and educators, you can take a look at the website education.vex.com/vr/, and that also links you to a bunch of lessons beyond the course of what's included in this resource. We're going to be looking at some virtual playgrounds, and what's really great is the challenges and activities are editable by teachers. VEXCode VR platform looks as you see on the screen here, and it is based on a block coding platform, which some students may be used to. A lot of students mention that this looks very similar to the CS4 Scratch platform, and a lot of the block coding programs are meant to look this way. By clicking on the link at the bottom, you can link into a further resource that discusses more aspects of the VEX robot. As you can see, there are these basic blocks and a bunch of different command examples that go along with it. You have your hat blocks, your stack blocks, your Boolean blocks, reporter blocks, and your C blocks. So if you were to look in a physical form, the VEX robot looks like this. What you'll notice when we start doing the activities is that you will see that the virtual simulator version looks very similar to this. And it is possible that some schools will have access to this robot. For a lot more activities that have been collected, you can click on the link at the bottom. We're going to go over some of these together. This is the first challenge that we're going to look at today. And we're going to do this one together. And what you'll notice is there's a couple features that I want you to pay attention to. Is we're going to be using the grid map playground, and we're going to look at level 1, moving the robot forward by 3 grid squares. Level 2, moving the programming the VR robot to drive forward 6 squares, turn around and drive back 6 squares, and the further one would be programming the VR robot to drive in a square, three grid squares long. We're going to do level one and level two together so you can see what the platform looks like. And when you select on the VEX Code VR website, you might be asked to click on some other features. Always click on the continue to free or student friendly version. As you see here, this is the software, the area where we're going to build our code, and our command blocks are all located on the left side, and they are color coded to help us out. Okay, so based on the challenge, what we're going to do right now is we're going to select the playground. And you'll notice that some of the playgrounds are coming soon and some require the premium license. We're not going to use those. And based on challenge task number one, we're going to find the grid map, which looks like this. And it should load up pretty quickly. And what you'll see here is this is the simulated robot, and your robot's located down there. There are three views of the robot. You can look directly from above. You can look right behind the robot itself, and you can also be a camera situated right on the robot. So in remembering, challenge one said that the robot had to move three grid spaces. And if I just click on this really quickly, it did say that a hint is that each grid square is 200 by 200. So what we want to do is we want to have the robot move forward. Now, if you were to drive the robot forward without a number or a measured distance, it may just drive right off the grid itself. So what we're going to do is we're going to actually have the robot drive forward. And remember that 200 was just one grid square. So if we think of moving three grid squares, we can multiply this by three, and we get 600. So far there's our code. Now we're gonna test the code out, press play, and the robot moves forward one, two, and three, and it has stopped. Wonderful. Let's reset it, and let's take a look at what it might look like in this view as well. So we press play, and it goes forward three grid spaces. Wonderful. And just because there are three viewpoints, let's take a look at the from a camera on top of the robot, pressing play, moving one, two, and three. Fantastic. So we have completed level one, which was driving the robot forward by three grid squares. And now we're going to program the robot to move forward six, turn around, and drive back six. So going back to our VR, we know that the original code here was 600 millimeters, and that went three spaces. So now we need six. So we can multiply this again, and we can get the number of, well, we want it to be double what it was. So we can just multiply it by two and go to 1,200. Let's test it out. One, two, three, four, five. And that would be six. Great. Now remember, the second part was that it needed to turn around. So there are a bunch of turning options, and you can experiment with it. My advice is to grab the turn right, and you could also say turn left. That is, you know, your call. And remember, if we're going to do a turn, 90 degrees would not be enough. So we are going to adapt it, and we're going to go 180 degrees. Now let's see what happens when we click this. We have the robot going forward and making a 180 degree turn. Perfect. And the rest of the code says that we need to have the robot drive back to where it began. You are more than welcome to do a copy, duplicate the code, or you can simply just grab another drive forward. And we remember that this was 1200 forward with a 180 degree turn, and we'll turn this over to 1,200 as well. And let's test the robot, see if we're happy with it. Six forward, making a 180 degree turn, and back to starting point. So congratulations, you've coded the robot to move. And again, let's just check out the other views. Here's the robot going forward, doing a 180 degree turn, and making its way back to the starting point. And then of course, I will do the other one as well. And we'll take a look at from the robot's point of view, going forward, making the 180 degree turn, and then bringing ourselves back to the starting point. Excellent. So if we go back to our slide deck here, you can take a look at the level 3 and you can do the robot drive in a square on your own and see if you can figure out that task. The second challenge here, I'm only going to do part of it so that you can see this is developing algorithms and we're calling it Crash the Castle. So if we were to go back to our VEX code, I'm going to close our playground. Then I'm going to get rid of the code that we already had. And I'm going to find the playground, which was Castle Crasher. And that would be this one here. And this playground looks very different than the other playground. As you can see, you have these 5 structures. If you take a look from different point of view, you can see what's there. And so this challenge, in a variety of ways, it basically asks you to knock over all of the 5 buildings using your code. So just for example, if you want to drive forward, and I think that's the best way to start, we'll look at driving this robot directly forward to knock this structure down. 200 is probably not enough. I'm going to go a little bit higher and type in 1,500. And let's just test to see what this looks like. And there we go. We've knocked over. And because we have the other views available, why don't we have a look to see what it looks like with this one? And then you can see that you've toppled it over. So you can take a look at that and you can work through the code on your own. And those are some activities that exist with Crashing the Castle. If you look at the next task that we have here, this is a drawing house activity, and this uses a different playground that exists on the VEX VR, and that is the art canvas. And so, of course, if you go back to your VEX Code VR, I'm just going to get rid of my code, and I'm going to find the art canvas. Make sure you pick the correct one. And the art canvas looks like this. And the commands are the same. A couple hints with this one. Make sure you set the pen color. And also you make sure to move the pen down so that it actually draws when you are moving the robot. And you can also take a look at the width. The further one that is after the draw the house is an activity with a number maze. And similarly, you can go through and select the playground and look at the dynamic maze itself. And there's a set of activities that you can go through. We have a challenge for you, is as such. The challenge is to create a Skills Ontario VEX Code VR logo. And the playground that we would like you to use is the Art Canvas playground, which is from one of the activities that you have seen. So using the Art Canvas playground, you're going to create a new Skills Ontario VEX Code VR logo. If you want some inspiration for some ideas, please visit the Skills Ontario website, and it is linked right there on the highlighted part. So the robot needs to create the logo with the code without stopping. You can use as much space as you like in any shape, colors, designs. However, your design has to be school appropriate and, of course, approved by your teacher. You will need to submit some type of short video or video capture of the robot creating the logo, as well as a copy of the code itself. And you can do this with a screenshot. You can even just use a personal device or camera to take a picture of the code. You can use a Screencastify or other type, even a Google Meet or other type of video recording your computer. Or again, you can just grab a tablet or a phone or some other device to do a recording. You're not going to be evaluated on the quality of the recording, but evaluated on the code and the design itself. There is an evaluation schema, which we'll show you on the next slide, and we are asking that all submissions be submitted no later than October 25th, 2022, with the assistance of your teacher. And that information will be going out a little bit after this week, after the International Day of the Girl event. Teams are permitted up to 3 students, so it could be 1, 2, or 3 students. You can work together on this challenge. The evaluation will be based on 3 criteria: the efficiency of your code, the design clarity, and the design creativity. So please feel free to be as creative as possible. And if you have any questions, please direct them to Skills Ontario and myself, and we'll be happy to provide you with some assistance. For students and for educators, the last part of the tutorial involves some coding resources, which you may find helpful. For educators, we're always thinking about assessment, and we're always thinking about using assessment to improve student learning. And teachers in Ontario, we would advise you to look through the Growing Success, the math curriculum, as well as the science curriculum, and looking at the areas and expectations that you'd like to cover. As well, we are always looking at different types of assessment, assessment for learning, and assessment of learning, so that we're providing dynamic assessment for our students and basing our work and our lessons and instructions on the needs and learning styles of our students. If you take a reference here, teaching coding tips, student assessment, there's always a temptation to ask to assess code line by line. But it's recommended to go beyond sort of traditional tests and assignments and sort of look at a big picture. The coding itself is really not the specific code, but it's the process and skills that are developed and the problem-solving resilience and creativity that are embedded in activities such as this. Different types of examples of coding that you can see and they are on the screen for you to take a look at. And, you know, always advisable to do a variety of different types of assessment so that your students have different methods to be able to show their learning. There are coding resources within the mathematics curriculum online from the Ministry of Ontario Education, Ministry of Education of Ontario. Ontario Association of Math Educators, OAME, has a great website that has resources as well. TVO Learn, definitely has some activities related to coding. And of course, coding fits into the algebra strand. If you click on the link that is provided and shared with everybody, you'll see some of the mathematics connections that can be done with the particular VEX Code VR activities that have been linked in this presentation. As well, for educators, there is a great short video that you can watch that was broadcast through TVO Teach Ontario, and it has some great ideas and overall structure for coding that relates to elementary. Thank you, everybody, for joining us for this virtual tutorial for the VEXCode VR virtual robot. We hope you enjoyed and you were able to learn some new skills, and we encourage you to try out the activities as well as the challenge. Any questions related to the challenge, please direct them to Skills Ontario at the email address that was sent to your teachers through your teachers. Once again, my name is Michael Frankfort, and thank you again for joining me on this short tutorial. Skills Ontario would like to thank their partners, GM, Magna, Canadian Government, Employee Ontario, and the Government of Ontario. Please feel free to connect with Skills Ontario on all the following social media that exists at the bottom of this slide. As well, notice the hashtag for the International Day of the Girl event, hashtag SkillsIDG2022. Thanks again, and have a great rest of your day.